This is Ms. Barnacle again. Our last lesson in this particular set of modules is dividing mixed numbers. So we're going to work a few of these on the board. And if you notice, here's our screen. Earlier when we did multiply mixed numbers, I taught you how to take a recipe, whatever the measurements are, and double it if you want to, you know, make enough for two sets of people. You can also do the same thing with dividing. You can take a recipe and cut it in half if you're only making enough for two people or enough for one person. So that's what I'm fixing to do, is I'm going to show you how to take mixed numbers and cut them in half or divide them into however many parts we need to. Okay, going to the board. So this first one says, if I have 1.5 cups of chocolate chips and I want to divide it into two equal parts, what is this understood? Now, we just got through talking about this. All whole numbers have an understood one under them. So I want to, again, anytime you're dealing with mixed numbers, turn them to improper fractions. It just makes it easier to do. So we do 2 times 1 is 2, plus 1 makes 3. So that would be 3/2. And remember, you flip the second and multiply. So when I flip the second, now I'm changing 2/1 to 1/2, and I'm going to multiply that together. So I have, look at my fractions. Can I reduce anything? No. So since I can't reduce anything, I do top times top, bottom times bottom, and that leaves me 3/4 of a cup. So from 1.5 down to 3/4, if I wanted to half the number of chocolate chips I'm putting in this recipe. Okay, what if I have 1 1/3 cups of butter? Because you know you want to cut that in half as well. So put a 1 under your 2 and do the multiplication. 3 times 1 is 3, plus 1 makes 4, so that's 4/3. Change, divide to multiply, and do the reciprocal. Remember, flip the second. And now, can I reduce anything? Yes, I can reduce 4 and 2. 2 divides into 2 1 time, 2 divides into 4 2 times. Once you've done that, then you do top times top, bottom times bottom, and that leaves me 2/3 of a cup of butter, okay? Now that's just talking about recipes. Well, what if you want to just do basic divide mixed numbers, okay? That's what's on this last problem. I have 2 mixed numbers, so you want to take them both and change them into improper fractions. So I do 10 times 3 is 30. Plus 3 is 33, so that'd be 33 over 10. Change, divide to multiply. And this would be 5 times 2 makes 10, plus 1 makes 11, right? So that'd be 11 over 5, but remember this is dividing, so we have to flip the second and multiply. So now we flip it. So anytime you're multiplying or dividing two mixed numbers together, you're going to change them to improper fractions. But on dividing, after you change it to an improper fraction, then you're going to flip it over, okay? Now, once you go through this process, then the last step is to do what? Look to see if there's anything you can divide by. Well, 11 and 33, they have something in common. It's 11. 11 divides into 11 once. 11 divides into 33 three times. And then I'll look at 5 and 10. 5 divides into 5 once. 5 divides into 10 two times. Again, once you've done all the reducing you can do, top times top leaves me 3. Bottom times bottom leaves me 2, and that's 3/2. Or if you're doing something more specific and you need to change it to a mixed number, 2 divides into 3 one time, right? And that leaves 1/2 left over. So 3/2 and 1 1/2 mean the exact same thing. They represent the same amount of information. Okay, we have covered everything in this module, talking about fractions and mixed numbers, multiplying and dividing. And I hope you've learned something. If you need to go back, remember to print out all the notes. They're there for you with the examples worked out to help you when you take your quiz at the end.